What's up, friends? I'm a little nervous today because we're gonna attempt to launch this boat by myself. No help, not even Vita, the camera guy, is gonna help me today. And I've never done it before. So we've got a 28-foot triple axle. Not the biggest, definitely not the smallest. There's a good chance I'm gonna screw up, but I'm gonna take you on the journey and hopefully you'll learn with me. So we're gonna see how it goes. All right, so before we of course go up to the ramp, we don't wanna be that guy or that gal that's causing everybody to wait. Now luckily, there's nobody at the ramp today. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't be doing this because it's too embarrassing anyway. So why don't I just show it to millions of you on the interwebs? Now, we're in the staging area right now. So before we get to the ramp, we take care of all of our stuff in the staging area. So what have we done so far? Well, I've got my engines ready to roll. So I've taken the safety clips off of the engines. I've put them down, not all the way, but I've put them down much of the way so that they're gonna be in the water, ready to go. No time wasted. I've also taken off the straps in the back, made sure my plugs are in. I've made sure my batteries are on. I've even turned the key in my engines so that I can just immediately hit the start button. Oh, by the way, I wanna just reference a particular video online from Boating Local. It's one of the best solo boat launch videos I've ever seen. So a lot of the stuff that I'm gonna do today, I learned by watching that. Now, I haven't really learned it because I haven't done it with this. I have launched this boat with someone, I think 3 times, but I've never done it by myself. So this is the part that is the, we'll see how long it takes type of deal. All right, now we got fenders on the boat. Why do we got fenders? We got fenders because it's not the best ramp. They don't have any protection on the ramp. It's not a floating dock. In fact, it's a really steep ramp. Like I said, the dock has no rub rails or anything like that. So I've got my fenders on here just to make sure that we don't jack anything up on this beautiful Steiger craft. Also, I want to point out how we've got 2 different lines. So we've got a bow line, and this bow line already connected up top to a cleat, and you'll see that I've got some slack in it. Now the purpose of this is going to be as follows. I'm going to launch this without this strap being on. So before I actually go all the way down the ramp, I'm gonna take this strap off. I've already taken the other strap off. I'm gonna take this off. And you're like, how, well, isn't that dangerous? Well, you can't do that with a roller style trailer, but you can do that with a bunk style trailer. So because this is bunk style, it'll just sit on there. And what I can do is I can back it in, and hopefully when it hits the water and I just tap the brakes, it'll just slide right in. And this bow line will catch it. And then once it catches it, I'm gonna get out of my truck and I'm just gonna quickly grab this because it's just essentially, I've made it a loop, so it's gonna tighten. You'll see it'll tighten. It's gonna tighten, but the rest is just looped here. I'm gonna quickly take it off. I'm gonna use that as my bow line to grab. And then I've got a stern line as well. So my stern line, I've got it right here. And you're like, why is it right there? It's right there because I'm gonna grab it probably with my reach pole. And this way I have a stern line and I've got a bow line. So I've got 2 lines that I can hold on to if I need to at any point. They're ready for me. Again, all this is done in the staging area, plus any other prep, putting your coolers in, all that other junk that takes people forever. Okay, so now I think we might be ready to do this. Let's put the clock on the screen so we can see exactly how long it takes. Right, we're going down the ramp, baby. Now, as soon as I get it where I want it to be, I'm gonna hop out real quick and take off my strap. I hate this low tide. I'm worried we're gonna hit the ramp. We'll see. Check and see how things are going. Put my emergency brake on. Pretty close to the dock, about as close as I could possibly be here. So a little pushing it on that. And I'm gonna take this strap off and then we're gonna back it in. Hopefully it goes smooth. The only thing I'm worried about is there's a divot in this ramp because it's not a very good ramp, so I'm just a little bit worried about it shaking a little bit. I think I'm gonna keep the strap on just for that reason. But I'm gonna let it slack. All right, take on my parking brake. Don't forget that, Marcus. All right. Starting to go in. Parking brake. All right, I feel good about taking this off now. I'm not worried about the ramp anymore. I'm close enough. So I'm just gonna drop it in. I'm gonna let it pump out and we're gonna see hopefully if it does its job. Let's try this again. Down and release. And catch. Bling. Like magic. Still got my emergency brake on. You see that catch perfectly? So now I've got my bow line. It's good to go. I'm just gonna tie this off. Ain't got many places to tie off on this dock. Not many places. All right. All right, so now, good to go so far. I'm gonna take my stern line. I'm gonna tie it off down here. Big tie off, I don't need nothing there. Now I can pull the trailer out. Take off your emergency brake, dum-dum. All right. And away we go. Well, friends, you see the clock, you know how long it took. It was not perfect, but hey, it went pretty well, especially once I was sure that the ramp wasn't gonna have any major divots at the bottom and cause the trailer, you know, to do something crazy, because that's the worry with some of these ramps. Once I knew that, I was able to take that strap off so that we could just release it right into the water. We had the bow line catch it, so that worked perfectly, so that was great. And we struggled a little bit getting the stern line and everything together, but we got it. You notice this dock here doesn't really have much in terms of things to tie off onto. It doesn't have any rub rails. And so I think I could have done a little bit better in terms of where I positioned the fender, because if you look at this right now, the fender is a little bit back. So I think I could have done that a little bit better, but overall, not a bad experience. Hopefully you learned something today, my friends. And when you're launching that boat, you realize it's not so bad. This isn't the biggest boat, but it's definitely not small. It's bigger than most of the ones that you see on these single launch videos on the interwebs. We're gonna be using this all summer long, having lots of journeys on the Chesapeake Bay. Of course, we're gonna be down in North Carolina as well. Pirates Cove Marina, on speechless, with the professor, having incredible offshore experiences there too. We hope you're a part of the community. Make sure you share this with your friends, with your family, share the video, like the video, subscribe, do all those things because it really makes a big difference. We've hit 1,000 subscribers. We're just getting started. Eventually, we're gonna be 1 million subscribers. You heard it here first. And so, friends, thank you for being part of the community. As always, stay salty.